Good evening, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Just trying to check if you're still awake.
Got you.
Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat. Sa lahat ng Pilipino. That is how we say good afternoon in Filipino or in Tagalog or Tagalog. First is my sincerest gratitude to our beloved Bishop Michael Barber, to our pastor, Father Jimmy, to the Diocesan Director of the Society of the Propagation of the Faith, and of course to all of you here for welcoming me to your parish, St. Callistus, and also for giving me this opportunity to make this mission appear. By the way, I am Father Mark Aaron Corpus Riumanos. You may call me Father Aaron for short. I belong to the Philippine Disciples of Mary. Our community began in 1970 in the Philippines and was ecclesiastically established as a religious community of men in 1990. We are a young and small community of priests and seminarians. Our main ministry is to work among young people to provide them with moral and spiritual formation through leadership seminar workshop, values training formation, and youth empowerment programs. Having been in the Disciples of Mary for 15 years, 9 years as a seminarian, and 6 years as a priest, I have witnessed different ministerial challenges among our Filipino youth. I have heard stories of struggles to survive due to poverty, addictions, abuses, broken families, and other problems that continuously haunt them. Of the many situations that I encountered, one striking story surrounds a young man who was barely making it through the day. His family was very poor and could not even provide for his basic needs. So every day, he had to wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning to go to the wet market to work as an empty bottle collector, earning him $0.25 a day. His lunch simply consisted of a single fried egg and a cup of rice, the only food he had before going to school. He even confessed that he almost gave in to the temptation of selling drugs on the streets just for him to earn some money to survive. But God works in mysterious yet providential way. This young man joined our youth ministry, and this young man saw a community, a family who helped and supported him, and he became one of our active and contributing youth leaders. And this young man, who was looking for a spark of hope years ago, entered the seminary, and on May 17, 2008, was ordained to the priesthood. This story is just one among the numerous rewarding accounts of young people who benefited from our ministerial programs. The Disciples of Mary has a lot of success stories. At present, we have more than 250 volunteer teachers and 350 volunteer youth leaders assisting us in serving around 15,000 young people all over the Philippines. Two of our priests are serving as pastors in the poor mission churches in the Marmolejo Islands in the Pacific. In order to reach their church, the priest has to ride a small motorized boat for 8 hours to go to Patnanungan, Quezon, and 9 hours and at least 4 miles walk to go to Humalig, Quezon. The main source of living is fishing, and people are very poor. You might not believe me when I tell you that the monthly incomes of those parishes are barely $50. And our religious community financially supports these mission areas. Our readings, and especially the gospel for today, reminds us about the relationship of faith and love. That faith is a gift from God, And it's a gift to everyone. And it is only with true love that we can truly have that genuine faith. Just like in the gospel, the love of the mother for her daughter conquers everything. Even Jesus tested her for her faith. I believe as Christians, we are one. One in that faith, one in that love, and most of all, one in God. It is in this spirit of solidarity and oneness that I am here to request for your prayers. Please, pray for more vocations. Pray for us priests. And pray for my community that we may always continually work and serve the church. It is also in the spirit of solidarity and oneness that I ask for your financial support. Some of the seminarians come from less privileged families. Their parents are mostly farm workers and fishermen who cannot financially support their sons to the study or the preschool. I am here on behalf of the Filipino youth who are in need of your help. The hard financial situation in my ministries impels me to appeal to your generosity and kindness. I am aware of the economic crisis affecting your family, the United States, and the worldwide communities. That is why anything you do to help, anything, will be greatly appreciated. For the second collection, that will be for vocations, for the priests, and also for the Filipino youth who are poor, and for the mission churches in the Marlborough Islands in the Pacific. In advance, I would like to express my sincerest and deepest gratitude to all of you for helping us and supporting our mission. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. As we say in Filipino or in Tagalog, maraming, maraming, maraming salamat po. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, by the way, the young man who entered the seminary and became a priest 6 years ago, I believe his name is Father Aaron.